Everyone is familiar with how dangerous an asteroid can be. Having wiped out the dinosaurs, it has been established that a single asteroid from outer space is enough to destroy our tiny little planet completely. Today, we'll be talking about NASA's emergency preparedness drill with their recently launched DART mission, checking how safe the Earth is from extraterrestrial impacts. So how does NASA plan on testing this? And can this mission really save humanity from extinction? Check out these details in today's video. The NASA space mission, known as the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, is designed to test a means of planetary defense against near-Earth objects. A space probe will crash into the moon Dimorphous, which is orbiting the binary asteroid Didymos, on September 2022. To investigate the future potential of spacecraft impact to deflect an asteroid on a collision course with Earth via momentum transfer. NASA and the Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory collaborated on the DART mission. NASA's Planetary Defense Coordination Office is in charge, and other NASA laboratories and offices are giving technical assistance. International partners such as the space groups of the European Space Agency, Italian Space Agency, and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency are participating in related or following projects. NASA accepted the project in August 2018 to begin a final design and construction phase. DART was successfully launched on November 24, 2021, and the collision is set to take place between September 26th and October 2nd, 2022. Now, let's give a little background on the DART mission. Initially, the European Space Agency and NASA had separate plans for missions to test asteroid deflection tactics. Still, by 2015, they had formed a partnership named ADA, which is short for Asteroid Impact and Deflection Assessment, which involves two separate spacecraft launches that work in tandem. According to the proposal, AIM, the European spacecraft, would have launched in December 2020 and DART in July 2021. AIM would have orbited the larger asteroid in order to examine its composition and that of its moon. In September 2022, DART would collide with the asteroid's moon during a close approach to Earth. The asteroid's strength, surface physical qualities, and interior structure would have been researched by AIM, as well as the impact on the asteroid moon's orbit around the larger asteroid. The AIM orbiter was canceled, so the asteroids will not be fully characterized, and the repercussions of the DART hit will be tracked using ground-based telescopes and radar. In June 2017, NASA approved the project's transition from concept to preliminary design, and in August 2018, NASA cleared the project's transition to final design and assembly. DART was supposed to be a secondary payload on a commercial launch to keep costs down. But according to a mission update presentation in November 2018, the mission now has its own launch vehicle. DART will be launched on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket, NASA said on April 11, 2019. Scientists estimate that there are 25,000 big asteroids in the solar system. However, only around 8,000 have been discovered so far. As a result, NASA officials believe it is critical to prepare an effective plan in the event that a near-Earth object threatens Earth. The DART spacecraft is a 610-kilogram impactor with no scientific payload other than a sun sensor, a star tracker, and a Didymos reconnaissance and asteroid camera for optical navigation with a 20-centimeter aperture, otherwise known as DRACO. DRACO will provide autonomous navigation to impact the asteroid's moon near its center, and is based on the long-range reconnaissance imager on board the New Horizons probe. The NASA Evolutionary Xenon Thruster, or Next Ion Thruster, a type of solar electric propulsion, is used by the DART mission. The 3.5 kilowatts needed to power the 240 square foot solar arrays will generate enough propulsion equal to a commercial jet engine. A tiny piece of the DART solar array is configured to exhibit transformational solar array technology, which features very high efficiency solar panels and reflecting concentrators that provide three times the power of current solar array technology, using ROSA or roll-out solar arrays as the structure. The DART spacecraft is the first to use a spiral radial line slot array, a new form of high-gain communication antenna. The antenna uses the X-band NASA Deep Space Network frequencies of 7.2 and 8.4 gigahertz. The constructed antenna meets all of the specifications and has been thoroughly tested in various situations, resulting in a simplified design. DART's launch preparations began on October 20, 2021, when the spacecraft's fueling began at the Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. After a cross-country journey, the spacecraft arrived at the base near Lompoc in early October. Since then, DART team members have been testing the spacecraft's mechanics and electrical system, wrapping the final sections in multi-layer insulation blankets, and simulating the launch sequence from both the launch site and the Mission Operations Center at APL. On October 26, 2021, DART arrived at the SpaceX Payload Processing Facility at the Vandenberg Space Force Base. 2 days later, the team was given permissions to fill DART's fuel tank with about 50 kilograms of hydrazine propellant for spacecraft movements and attitude control. DART also transports around 60 kilograms of xenon for the NEXT-C ion engine. Engineers began connecting the spacecraft to the adapter that sits on top of the SpaceX Falcon 9 launch vehicle on November 10, 2021. The Falcon 9 rocket rolled for a static fire before returning to the processing facility, where SpaceX technicians installed the two halves of the payload fairing around the spacecraft over the course of 2 days, and the ground teams completed a successful flight readiness review later that week with the fairing attached to the spacecraft. On November 24, 2021, the DART spacecraft was launched into orbit. According to early plans, DART was supposed to be launched into a high-altitude orbit of the Earth to avoid the Moon. DART would escape from its high Earth orbit into a slightly inclined near-Earth solar orbit, from which it would start moving towards the path where the expected collision with its target would occur. Using its low-thrust, high-efficiency ion engine, this would be made possible. However, because DART was launched as a special Falcon 9 mission, the payload and the Falcon 9 second stage were placed on a direct Earth escape trajectory. DART has a first-of-its-kind electric thruster and lots of xenon fuel. Still, Falcon 9 completed practically all the work, leaving only a few trajectory correction burns with simple chemical thrusters as it approaches Didymos' moon Dimorphous. The impact of the 500-kilogram DART at 6.6 kilometers a second is expected to create a velocity change to the asteroid. Though the change will be only minor, it will become significant over time. The process of changing its course from such a minor alteration in velocity over a period of years could reduce the probability of a potential Earth-bound asteroid colliding with the planet. The impact will hit Dimorphous' center, reducing the orbital period, which is currently 11.92 hours, by about 10 minutes. The actual orbital shift and velocity change will be unknown. The contribution of recoil momentum from the impact causes a poorly understood momentum augmentation effect. One of the mission's key goals is to collect good measurements of the effects, which will assist in updating models of such collisions. Within a week, preliminary estimates of the shift in the orbital period should be available. A spacecraft named Hera, approved by ESA in November 2019, will perform a full check, trial, and assessment a few years later. Dimorphous, in the Didymos system, a binary asteroid system in which one asteroid orbits a smaller one, is the mission's target. The major asteroid has a diameter of around 780 meters, and its minor satellite, Dimorphous, has a diameter of around 160 meters and orbits the primary at a distance of around 1 kilometer. Didymos's mass is estimated to be 528 billion kilograms, with Dimorphous weighing in at 4.8 billion kilograms. Didymos is not an Earth-crossing asteroid, and the deflection experiment has little chance of causing an impact. So, that is how NASA and SpaceX are collaborating to keep our Earth safe. Do you think it'll be a success? Leave a comment below to let us know your thoughts. And while you're there, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.